If I were to describe this car and owning this car, just getting in and out of the vehicle, it's a very raw mechanical vehicle. You put the key in, you manually turn on the water pumps and the fans, and you have all your gauges. This is not a modern muscle car by any means. Seven horsepower, all motor, torque on demand, and it puts you in the back of your seat. What 700 sounds means to me is a passion for driving, horsepower. You really gotta be alert and be aware. It's extreme. There's no traction control on this car, no electronics. This is a raw American muscle car. Yeah, when I found this car and I started it up for the first time, I realized the Corvette was the platform. Found the diamond in the rough. I found this car in the Santa Cruz Mountains. I was told it was purchased at Yanko Chevrolet in Pennsylvania. The vision for this car, when you peel it back, was to keep it what it was, a Yanko Corvette. Don Yanko was a Corvette racer himself. He had won some titles in SCCA. He pushed to build production race cars. He put a lot of weight on GM and finally got him approved. It was really inspired to be a step up from just the Yanko Copo factory standard. We wanted to pay tribute to his actual race car. There's lots of modern underpinnings on this car that are there essentially so it can keep up with some of the modern cars. You think of these cars, you think they go fast. This thing vibrates like a Harley Davidson. It's got side pipes, exhaust right in your face. So that's why you have the coilovers, modern brakes, and harness and seats. So this car is sitting on an aluminum big block. It's pumping about 700 horsepower, 700 torque. You think of these cars, it's a classic American icon. It's made to burn rubber and shred tires. Grew up working at the Pomona Car Show, parking Corvettes. That really inspired me, watching the big block Chevys drive by, hearing the sound, the rumble. I owned a lot of modern muscle cars, but driving a classic, an American icon, get a lot of heads turning. You feel like a celebrity. It's not you, it's the car. It is a celebrity. People, when they see this car, they see a vintage American icon, and you could see it in their eyes. They pull their cell phones out. Kids that don't even know what this car is, they know. There's just something about the Coke bottle shape, the lines of this car, and the sounds that it makes. You really got to hear it in person. What's important to me about this car is what it represents. It represents an era where people had pride in their cars. It represents what the car was at the top of its level, at the top of its game. A lot of ideas behind these classic cars is that they were these perfect museum pieces, but there was a lot of imperfections on these cars. Build it to the point where you can handle driving it, and because these cars are meant to be driven, not just sitting in the garage. Get that motor running, make it rad, make it shred tires, get out on the open road, let loose. Yeah, this car is a full-blown experience. All your worries, you just leave them behind. I feel at one with this car. It's the closest thing to living in the moment. You can't hear your cell phone. You're not talking to the passenger. It's got so much power that you really have to feel it. You gotta be 100% present. It's just you and the car, and that's it.